Hi everyone, it's Lindy. Welcome back to my channel. Today I want to talk about international shipping on eBay. So I have done a previous video where I demonstrate and talk about shipping internationally direct through eBay's platform, but today I want to focus on the eBay Global Shipping Program and the brand new eBay International Delivery Service that's only been active since the last 6 months or so. At least I think it's in the last 6 months. Don't quote me on that because I've never personally used it. And I will be the first to admit, it took me a really, really long time before I started shipping directly international because I was super intimidated by the entire process. I didn't want to mess something up because I knew that international shipping labels were extremely expensive. I was concerned about what would happen if there was a return. I didn't understand exportation fees, and I still honestly don't understand exportation fees, but eBay does give us some tools that makes international shipping a little less intimidating, and that's what the eBay Global Shipping Program is. Now, one of the primary reasons why I felt international shipping was so intimidating wasn't necessarily the logistics of it, the cost of the label, how exactly I were to print that shipping label in the correct manner to make sure that it got to my international buyer. It wasn't so much that as it was being concerned about what exactly was prohibited in the country that I wanted to ship to. Because there are a lot of countries out there and it's very hard to know exactly what is prohibited to each one of those countries at any given time. Because I was really concerned that I was going to have to go through each individual listing that I wanted to ship internationally direct. I was going to need to know what items were prohibited and restricted in certain countries so that I could exclude those so I did not accidentally mail something that was restricted that could potentially get me in trouble. That was really overwhelming, so I just straight up said no international shipping for a very long time. I also resisted the eBay Global Shipping Program because I had heard that buyers would avoid sellers that use the eBay Global Shipping Program because of the outrageous fees. And so I just simply didn't check the box in the listing and I just sold domestically. But now I realize I was wrong. I was so wrong about the eBay Global Shipping Program. I have spent the last few months learning so much about eBay's Global Shipping Program. I wanted to go over everything that I have learned with you guys so that you might be inclined to try out that service so that you can broaden your customer base worldwide. Then I also want to compare it to the new eBay International Delivery Service so that you can decide whether or not you want to use both or one or the other, or if you just want to stick to shipping direct. So now before I go into all of the details about the eBay Global Shipping Program and everything that I have learned, I wanted to take a moment to thank the sponsor of today's video. Skillshare has been a longtime supporter of my YouTube channel. They love giving entrepreneurs the tools that they need to get better at their business. If you are unfamiliar with what Skillshare is, they are an online learning community that has over 20,000 classes that you can have access to learn different things. They have thousands of classes related to business, and those are by far my favorite. They have really fun classes about learning how to build brand logos. There's also classes about setting up a Facebook storefront. They even have classes talking about how to best market your home business. It is very quickly approaching the end of the year. It's starting to get cold outside for a lot of us, and so in my opinion, that is the perfect opportunity to cuddle up with a blanket, a hot cup of coffee, and take some courses online to better your business for 2021. Skillshare membership is super affordable. A premium membership is less than $10 per month. But if you sign up using my link that's down in the video description, you will get a free trial on the Skillshare site. Thank you again to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video, and now let's get on with the topic. So the eBay Global Shipping Program. I didn't realize how many benefits there were to the seller for using the eBay Global Shipping Program. Something else that didn't really occur to me was that you can actually select multiple international shipping options and give the buyer the choice of whether or not they want to go through the eBay Global Shipping Program or if they would rather use a more direct international shipping service. But if you only want to use the eBay Global Shipping Program, it will let the buyer know that that is the service, and if they still want to buy your item, then they're the one that makes that choice. So now let me talk about the things things about the eBay Global Shipping Program that I didn't realize was so awesome that makes me want to always opt into the eBay Global Shipping Program, even if I intend to use another international shipping service. Let me tell you the story of how I learned how awesome the eBay Global Shipping Program is, because this is what sparked my entire interest in wanting to make sure that every single item I have listed on eBay is eligible for the program. I sold a razor, and it wasn't just any men's razor. It was an expensive, brand new, sealed in the box Panasonic razor. I had the razor listed around $110 with free shipping, and I received a $99 offer from a buyer that I eagerly accepted. Then right after I accepted, I realized this buyer is out of the country. And I've discussed in my previous international shipping video that I will link up here in the iCards. I'll also put it down in the video description. I discussed the certain kind of items that I like to ship overseas and the countries that I will ship directly to. But I can tell you, a $100 razor is not something I want to send international, because that's a lot of money to risk if something happens on the way, or if there's no tracking, or if the buyer wants to return it because they're not happy. I would much rather ship things that are under $50 that I don't mind eating the cost of if there's a problem upon delivery, because I do not accept international returns. And if a buyer happens to open an item not as described return, you have to pay the exportation fees and the return shipping label that can get really expensive. And that's what happened with this buyer. You see, I didn't opt for direct international shipping on this particular listing. Instead, this listing was enrolled in the eBay Global Shipping Program, and I didn't realize it. The buyer paid instantly, and I just thought to myself, oh boy, we're gonna see what happens. Because I didn't want to cancel the order just because the buyer was overseas, because they paid so quickly and it was $100. So I went ahead and I shipped the razor through the eBay Global Shipping Program and eagerly awaited what was going to happen. And of course, my worst nightmare happened. Yep, the buyer received the razor and they sent me a message stating that the razor was not as described, that I had stated that the razor was brand new, which it was. And when they received it, the razor had been opened and it appears as though it was used, which I know that razor was brand new sealed. Anytime I get anything like razors or electric toothbrushes, I make sure that that factory seal is in place. Otherwise, I'll list it as open box or used. This one, I remember specifically, was factory sealed, never been opened, so I was pissed. Then this buyer immediately opens a return, and I received notification of this return, and I was going to have to refund this buyer $147. $147. Keep in mind, the original purchase price was $99, meaning I was going to have to cough up an extra $48 on top of the original purchase price because of exportation fees. This was not including the return shipping label, I'll mind you. When a buyer opens an item not as described return, the cost of the shipping label gets added onto your invoice in most cases. So this $147 estimated refund was only the exportation fees that the buyer had paid to eBay for the eBay Global Shipping Program and their original purchase price of $99. I was livid. This is why I don't sell things internationally that are that expensive. So I called eBay. I was not on the phone with the eBay representative for more than 5 minutes before they told me, no problem, we'll send them their refund, have a good day. They said that to me and I was over here like, whoa, 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 whoa. You're just gonna send them a refund? Are you pulling it out of my PayPal account? And the rep kind of laughed and she said, no, no, we are just going to refund them because you are protected under the eBay Global Shipping Program seller protection. What? Tell me more. So I asked her to educate me on the eBay Global Shipping Program because this was definitely not what I expected. And what she told me was that after the item is received at the distribution center for the eBay Global Shipping Program, eBay takes full responsibility of the condition of the item, and they stand behind it and they protect the seller in the event that the item arrives to the buyer in any different, damaged, or item not as described kind of situation. And the reason for this that she told me was because there are mistakes that can be made at the distribution center, and there's no way to know if the buyer actually received the item that I originally shipped or if packages got mixed up. So it very well could have been that this buyer received a razor that wasn't the one that I originally sent. It also could have been the kind of situation where the razor was opened at the distribution center, which to me is really crazy. I don't understand why they would open up the razor box because this buyer claims that it was used. I could understand if maybe they opened up the box at the distribution center to verify that the contents inside were what the box said it was, you know, to make sure that there wasn't a restricted item in this box. But the buyer said that this was used. So I don't know if they got the wrong razor or if the buyer was just trying to get one over on eBay. Because sometimes international buyers can be scammy, which is another reason why I don't like to send items over $50 internationally. But what I learned through this dialogue with this eBay rep, I started asking lots of questions, and what I learned was if the seller sends something overseas using the eBay Global Shipping Program, there is complete and total protection in all ways. That means if the item arrives damaged, eBay will refund the buyer, seller keeps the money. If the buyer claims that they received the wrong item, eBay refunds the buyer, seller keeps the money. Basically, if the international buyer is unhappy in any form or fashion, eBay refunds the buyer, seller keeps the money. And this is not the only time this has happened. There was another instance that I went through where a buyer claimed that they received, get this, international buyer received a poly bag with someone else's address on it inside of a poly bag that had their address on it and nothing else. No item, nothing. They received a poly bag addressed to them that had someone else's poly bag with someone else's address, empty bag inside of it. Yeah, why? I don't know. But I reached out to eBay because the buyer reached out to me to tell me that not only did they not receive the item that they purchased from me, but they received an empty baggie instead. So I reached out to eBay. eBay refunded the buyer. I got to keep my funds. Done. I've also had an instance where I shipped bacon bits. Yes, bacon bits, like the kind that you shake on top of your salad. I had shipped bacon bits through the eBay Global Shipping Program overseas. eBay notified me that it turned out to be a restricted item, so the item had to be destroyed. I still got to keep the money. The buyer got their refund. Because here's the thing, it's eBay's responsibility to know these prohibited items and what is restricted in certain countries so that they can eliminate those countries for the eBay Global Shipping Program. So all you have to do is check the box in the listing that says that the item is eligible for the eBay Global Shipping Program. And if eBay attempts to send a restricted or prohibited item, they take full responsibility, the buyer gets their refund, and you as the seller are harmed in no way. So all of this tells me, why in the world wouldn't you use the eBay Global Shipping Program? So by now I'm assuming you're a little bit excited about the eBay Global Shipping Program, but you don't exactly understand what it is. So let me describe very quickly exactly what it entails, what's all involved, and then we'll get on to this new eBay International Delivery Service. So while you are creating your eBay listing, there is a little box that you can check that opts that listing into the eBay Global Shipping Program. And if you check that box and send your listing live, then that means that all of the buyers in the applicable countries can purchase your item and pay an extra fee to eBay to have that item delivered to them. And all you need to do as the seller is ship that item to Kentucky. So if you have free shipping on that item, it's almost like your buyer is in Kentucky. You just have to ship it there and that's it. You are not responsible for any additional fees. So as long as your package arrives in Kentucky, eBay takes full responsibility from there, and it's at no cost to you as the seller. So now this is also another reason why people say that the eBay Global Shipping Program is way too expensive for the buyers. But as a seller, if you want to broaden your customer base, this is a very, very easy and unintimidating way to do that. You don't have to fill out any customs forms. You don't have to worry about whether or not your item is restricted in that country. All you have to do is ship the package to Kentucky. eBay takes it from there. To answer your next question, yes, I am almost positive that every single seller on eBay is eligible to ship with the eBay Global Shipping Program. Do not believe you have to have a store subscription. You might have to go into your account settings and make sure that it's enabled, but it's just a little box that you check mark within the eBay listing itself. And no, you don't have to send all of your items international if you don't want to. You can dictate that on each individual listing as you see fit. So now let's talk really briefly about this new eBay International Delivery Service. Full disclosure, I have not personally used the new eBay International Shipping Service, but I have used the benefit of my eBay concierge telephone number to call up and speak with eBay reps directly to get a handle on what exactly this service is and why it might be better than the regular standard United States Postal Service international delivery, or why you might want to use that instead of the eBay Global Shipping Program. And now what I've learned is that with the eBay Global Shipping Program, you are covered 100% seller protections. However, with the eBay International Delivery Service, you are not. It's very similar to standard international delivery in that sense, but the difference between the standard international delivery service and the eBay International Delivery Service is that there are more countries that offer door-to-door tracking, and you also get $100 in free insurance. So now with standard international shipping service, there's no insurance unless you pay for it or you're sending it priority service. And then in that case, you will get the standard, I think it's either $50 or $100 insurance. But with the eBay International, every single package has a $100 insurance policy. I've also been notified that the purpose of eBay's international shipping service is that the prices should be the same, if not better, than just sending it through the regular international shipping service. Again, I can't confirm this because I haven't ever used it myself, but if I do end up getting an international delivery here soon, I will most definitely check the difference between the standard international delivery versus the eBay international delivery. They did also tell me that if the eBay international delivery is significantly more than the standard international, to make sure to let them know, because the whole purpose of the eBay International Delivery Program is to make the prices better, to give you a little bit more of a discount. It's also to give you that additional $100 of insurance, and it's also to provide more countries tracking door to door. Now, I mentioned in that video, this international video that I've linked up here, I have mentioned that there are only a few countries that I will ship directly to because there are a lot of countries out there that don't offer door-to-door tracking. And what will end up happening is your package will leave the United States, it will arrive in the country, but you have no idea if it was actually delivered to your buyer. And when that happens, the buyer can reach out to you and say, hey, I never received my package. You don't have any tracking to protect you. So chances are you're going to have to refund that buyer and you'll never see that package again. But from what I'm told, the eBay International Delivery Service has more countries that have door-to-door tracking that protects you a little bit more than just the standard international service. However, if a package ends up getting lost, eBay does not cover the seller like it does for the eBay Global Shipping Program. But you do have that free $100 insurance. And I did ask specifically how exactly you would file that insurance claim because you bought it through the eBay International Delivery Service. And I was notified that in the orders page, in the little drop down where you would go to select to refund your buyer, anything like that, that is where you would open an insurance claim for eBay's international delivery. You can also contact them and have them open the claim for you. I think the next time that I do get an international sale, I will be more likely to use the eBay International Shipping Service because of the free $100 insurance and because there's a higher likelihood that more countries have door-to-door tracking that allows you to see whether or not your package actually arrived at your buyer's door. And I would assume that the way you print the shipping label through the eBay International Delivery is very similar to the standard international delivery, and that is also not very hard. I actually demonstrate shipping a package to Canada in that video that I linked here and down in the video description. The customs form is not intimidating at all. It's really as simple as checkmarking a box and making sure that the shipping weight is accurate. And the customs form and the shipping label all prints in one label. So there's not additional forms that you have to make sure to attach to the package. It's very straightforward, very simple. It's just like printing any other shipping label, except this one has a different kind of tracking number and it has some customs form information embedded in the delivery slip. So whether or not you want to utilize the eBay Global Shipping Program or International directly, I highly recommend that every seller broadens their customer base and tries shipping to other countries rather than just domestic. Because you never know how much more you'll be able to sell. You never know how many buyers are looking for your particular item that they can't get where they live. So now I want to hear from you. Let me know down in the comments below, do you currently use eBay's Global Shipping Program? Do you currently ship International Direct? Do you do both? Because you can do both and let the buyer choose which option they would like. If you like this video and videos like it, please do give it a thumbs up. That lets me know that you like it. It also lets YouTube know that other people might like it as well. Don't forget to check the video description. I will put a lot of useful information in there as well as the link to get you a free trial on Skillshare's site. And if you haven't already, please remember to subscribe and ring the notification bell. That way you'll be notified whenever I post a new video. Thank you guys again so much for watching. I will see you with my next video. Bye-bye.